If you've ever wanted to format your data based on specific values that are happening within it, then this is exactly the video you need. We'll start with formatting cells based on their own value, and then we'll look at how to format cells based on another cell's value. The data we have today is the past 4 years of avocado sales, both price and volume information for the US market. Let's look at the price. Let's say we want to see high and low prices, or above and below a certain amount. Let's highlight all of the prices that are below a dollar per avocado. To do this, we're going to select our data. Because all of my column B has this price information, I'm going to go ahead and click on column B. Now I'm going to go here and click on conditional formatting and select highlight cell rules less than, and here I'm going to type in $1. And I'm going to leave the light red fill with dark red text, though you can go ahead and format that however you'd like, and click OK. So immediately we see here we have one value already in 2019 where the average price was below a dollar. If I scroll down more through my data, looks like last May, last February, and a few other times in the past, the prices have been low. 2017 looks like it was a great year if you like eating avocados. Let's say I also want to know when the price seems a little bit on the high side. So let's go back here, click on this to highlight column B, go to our conditional formatting, and add a rule that we want to see any value that's greater than $1.50 per avocado. And in this case, let's highlight those with a green fill so that we can see some difference. Click OK. All right, now we don't have anything on our first page here that's over $1.50, but if I scroll down, looks like September and October of 2017 were particularly expensive months for avocado eaters. And if we go through our data, we're likely to find some other times when things were high. Actually, it looks like back to 2015, we had more times where avocados were below a dollar than they were above $1.50. So that's great if you want to go ahead and format those specific cells. But let's say I want to change what I'm looking at each time. I'm going to go here and clear all my conditional formatting by going to conditional formatting, clear rules, and I'm going to go ahead and clear them for the entire sheet so I don't have anything formatted. Let's say instead of highlighting those individual cells and manually plugging in $1.50 or $1 as my rules, I want to put a low price and a high price, and I want to be able to plug in what those are. So let's use the same amounts. I'm going to use $1 for my low price and $1.50 for my high price. Let me go ahead and format these quickly as money so they're easy to see. And let's say I'm going to go ahead and format price based on these values. So very similar process. We highlight column B, and first we're going to do our low price. Come over to conditional formatting, highlight your cell rules that are less than, and here we'll go ahead and click this arrow beside this $1.21 that automatically pops up, and we're going to click on our cell. In this case, it's M3, that has that dollar price in it. And you can already see it started highlighting something red. And we're going to keep that with light red fill with dark red text. Click OK. So now we have that same value, but if we want to change it, let's say we want to say a low price is actually below 90 cents, I can quickly change that and my formatting changes. Maybe we want to say a low price is below $1.20. In that case, most of my cells start changing color because there's a lot in that range. I'm going to put this back at $1 and let's do the same thing for the high price. So again, go back here, click on column B, go to conditional formatting, highlight cell rules, greater than, and we're going to do greater than M4, hit enter, and let's change that formatting just so we're not highlighting our lows and highs the same, and click OK. And you'll notice sometimes text will format a little strangely. with those financial figures. That's not really something you need to worry about in here. So as we scroll down, again, we have that one period back in September, October of 2017, where the prices were above $1.50. But maybe a high price for me is if it's above $1.25. So if we go and put $1.25 in that high price, again, we start seeing more values that are exceeding that limit that are getting highlighted. It's really that straightforward. In about 5 minutes, we were able to format in a few different ways. If you want to take those rules off, again, just click on those cells, conditional formatting, clear your rules, and you can clear them from the entire sheet, or maybe you have other columns formatted that you want to keep or other cells formatted that you want to keep. You can just clear the rules from selected cells, and now everything's back to blank. Thanks so much for watching. Let me know what questions you have about doing conditional formatting in the comments below.